Hello students. Okay, till now we have learnt lesson number 1, lesson number 2, and now we are learning new lesson, and we have already started that new lesson. Name of the lesson is housing and clothing. Name of the lesson is housing and clothing. This is standard third, and third lesson we are learning about, and we are having name of the lesson is housing and clothing. Housing and clothing. Okay, we have already learnt in this lesson about the first point. The first point is good and clean house. Okay. What we have learnt in that first point, we have learnt about the features of good house. We have learnt features of good house, and the features of the good house are, I know you are knowing it very nicely, and the features of the good house are well lit, airy and clean. A house should be well lit, airy and clean. Yes, again we have learnt about the different features. That is, we should have wire netting to our houses, and we should have enough of sunlight, and also we have clean house. Again, we have wire netting to the doors and windows so that the mosquitoes, germs will not come inside, and we will again have the sunlight, enough of sunlight in our house, so that due to that sunlight germs will be killed, and again we have a fresh and clean our in house. For that, what we have to do? For that we should plant more and more trees around our house. More and more trees gives fresh and clean air. Okay, understood? Now how can we keep our house clean? Okay, how to keep our house clean? Yes, by throwing waste in the dustbin. By throwing waste papers, waste material in the dustbin. Again, we can sweep our house daily. Daily we should wipe out the dust from the house. Yes, again we should clean our floor daily. Daily we have to clean our floor by using some sort of germ killer. Okay, germ killer. By using that germ killer, we can keep our floor clean and nice. Also, we should keep our toilets and bathrooms clean. Again, we should keep our all things on proper place, so that we will not waste our time while we are in need of that thing. Okay, so this is all about the first point that we have already learnt, good and clean house. Now we are going to learn about second point, 3.2. We are going to learn about 3.2, and the name of the point is fiber. Name of the point is fiber. Now what is fiber? Yes. Fiber is exactly the material that is used for making different kinds of clothes. Okay, fiber is the material which is used for making cloth. Okay, understood everybody? Now fiber is again a thread like material. It is a thread like material. Yes, fiber, again I am repeating, fiber is thread like material. Okay everybody, understood this? Okay, now we are going to learn different kinds of fibers. First, I'm using this green chalk. Why I am using this green chalk? Because we are having the fibers that we are getting from nature. Okay, the color of trees is green. So I'm using this chalk, green chalk. Natural fibers, and we are having man-made fibers. Everybody, keep in mind there are two types of fibers, natural fiber and man-made fiber. Naturally, of course, natural fiber, that are the fibers available in nature, that we are not doing anything with. We are just picking that from naturally from plants or animals, and we are using that thread for making, again for making clothes. Okay, and what do you mean by natural fibers? Again I'm repeating, fibers that are available in nature, that are called natural fibers. Fibers available in nature that are called natural fibers. Clear? Very good. Now the man-made fiber, yes, the word says man. The fibers which are made by man, that are called man-made fibers. Fibers that are made by man are called man-made fibers. Okay, so now what we are going to do with this, we are going to learn everything again about this in deeply. Again, there are types in this. In this, there are types of natural fibers, and here there are no types because man-made, it made in factory. So it don't have any kind of fibers. Okay. Okay. So natural fibers, yes. There are two types in it. There are two types. Fibers that are obtained from plants. Fibers that are obtained from plants. Okay. And the natural fibers that are obtained from animals. Everywhere. Again, we are considering two types under this natural fiber, that are plants fiber and animals fibers. Yes, as the name says, the fibers that we are getting from plants, are called plants fiber. Very easy. Yes, is it? It is very easy. For example, cotton we are getting from plants, and we are getting cotton from cotton plant. Okay, and we are getting linen, we are getting this from flax plant. So these are the two examples that we are getting fibers from the plants. Okay, everybody, clear about the plant fibers. Okay, very nice. Moving further with the animals fiber. Yes, we are getting some threads from animals, and that are we are getting wool from sheep. We are getting wool from sheep. Yes, everyone. And we are getting silk. We are getting silk from silkworm. Clear? So this is the part about the natural fibers. Natural fibers are the fibers that we are getting from plants and animals. Now plants fiber, fibers which we are getting from plants, they are called plants fiber. Yes, very easy. And the examples, we are getting cotton from cotton plant, and we are getting linen from flax plant. Okay. Again, we are getting some fibers from animals that are also natural, and from this we are getting wool. We are getting wool from sheep, and we are getting silk from silkworm. Okay, wool is used for making woolen clothes, and the silk is used for making silk clothes. Okay, everybody clear? Okay. We are visiting different types of occasions, okay, and for that we are wearing these different kinds of clothes, okay. And what happens, you know, many of the times we are having a lot of clothes in our house, old clothes, and what we are doing with these old clothes, just we are throwing it away, okay. Besides throwing that clothes away, we can reuse that clothes. Okay, we can reuse that clothes for making bags, different kinds of bags, or for making different designed dresses. Okay, and besides throwing, also you can give away your old clothes to a poor persons who are needy. Those who are needy, to them you can give that clothes. So remember it and keep it in mind. Okay, now moving further with the man-made material. Very simple. Man-made material, man-made fibers are also called synthetic fibers. Man-made fibers are called synthetic fibers. Okay. For that, okay, so synthetic, another name for man-made fiber is synthetic fiber. Okay, so keep in mind there are two names for man-made fiber. Okay, man-made fiber also called as synthetic fibers. Okay, and the examples, nylon, acrylic, polyester. Okay, these are the material that are shiny, that gives shining, and it are these fibers are mostly you know, shiny, and they don't absorb water inside. Okay, so they just leave away the water. So the examples of these types of fiber, the clothes example of these types of fibers are raincoat, umbrellas. Okay, most of these types of shiny clothes are made up of man-made fibers. Okay, now why are we wearing clothes? Yes, we are wearing clothes to cover our body. We are wearing clothes. Why we are wearing? To protect our body. Okay, and again, why we are wearing? We are wearing clothes to protect our body from heat, cold, rain. Yes, we are wearing different types of clothes for protecting our body, and we are covering our body to protect it from heat, cold, and rain. Okay, again, we are wearing clothes to protect our body, and we are wearing different types of clothes. We are wearing different types of clothes in different kinds of season, such as in summer season we are wearing cotton clothes. In rainy season we are using the clothes which are waterproof, okay, which give protection from rain. And in winter season, of course, in winter season we are wearing clothes which are made up of woolen. So there are different seasons and there are different seasons, and in that different seasons we are wearing different kinds of clothes to protect our body. So all about is lesson number 3, and again we are going to repeating 3.2. today we have learnt. Next point in lesson number 3, point number 2, fiber. What is fiber? Fiber is thread like material. It is nothing but a thread. Okay, fibers have two types: natural fibers and man made fibers. Okay, again, natural fibers are the fibers that are obtained in nature. Fibers that we get from nature that are called natural fibers. Again, natural fibers are divided into two categories: plants fiber, animals fiber. Plants fibers are the fibers that we are getting from plant. Very easy. Animals fibers that we are getting from animals. Very easy. Plants, example, cotton. We are getting cotton from cotton plant. We are getting linen from flax plant. Okay, this is all about plants. Now animals fiber. Animals fiber, we are getting wool from sheep. We are getting silk from silkworm. And through wool, with the help of wool, we are making woolen clothes. And with the help of silk, we are getting silky, shiny, nice clothes. Again, okay, so these are all about the natural fibers. Man-made fibers are the fibers which are made by man. Very easy. Man-made fibers are the fibers which are made by man. And another name for man-made fiber is synthetic fiber. Man-made fibers are also called synthetic fibers. Okay, examples of these fibers: nylon, acrylic and polyester. Okay, this is all about man-made fibers. Now why we are wearing clothes? We are wearing clothes to protect our body from heat, cold and rain. We are wearing clothes. Why we are wearing? We are wearing clothes to protect our body from heat, cold and rain. Also, we are wearing clothes to cover our body. Okay. Now, we are wearing different types of clothes. We are wearing different types of clothes in different seasons. Okay. We are wearing different types of clothes in different types of seasons. Sorry. We are wearing different clothes in different types of seasons. In summer season, we are wearing cotton clothes. In rainy season, we are wearing waterproof clothes that protects us from rain. And in the winter season, we are wearing woolen clothes. So that's all about the lesson. The lesson is very simple. Okay, tomorrow I will send you the homework based on it and you have to solve it. Okay, so all the best. Prepare yourself. Okay, just read it for 1 minute. Read this everything for 1 minute.